Okay, so as we begin our introduction to the lumbar spine, just as we've talked about the thoracic spine being a primary restrictor of mobility into the cervical spine, guess what? Go ahead and turn around. Our primary restrictor is not going to be in the back, it's going to be part of our hip flexors. Our hip flexors connect onto the spine and to the pelvis, and those muscles being overactive or too tight, because they attach onto the lumbar spine, can be responsible for that low-grade back pain that most people get here. So if we can take some of the stress off of there by approaching it from the front side, this actually unlocks the lumbar spine. This will actually unlock mobility of the hips, which will create less stress onto the lumbar spine. And here we're going to instruct you in how to release the iliopsoas, as well as the tensor fasciae latae, the TFL, and then some of the other hip flexors that sit on the anterior part of the hip. When we release that, that's going to take some stress off of the low back. Okay? So we'll instruct you in that right now. So as you can see, we've lowered the backmate, we've tilted it down, and we've even created this 45 degree angle. What we're gonna approach here is not so much the roll, but what we're gonna do is actually do more trigger point therapy here. So as Janelle gets into this position here, she's gonna position herself in more of a stride lunge position here. We're getting the right hip here, the left foot is gonna be forward. By being in this stride position here, you can see she's actually put her hip flexors a little bit on stretch. And what she's gonna do here is just lean into the ball. Okay, so if we can have Janelle come off the ball just for a second, rotate over here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna find this is called our ASIS, or our little pelvic bone. We're gonna go just inside of that. That's where our iliopsoas is going to reside. So we're gonna go right in there, and all we're gonna do is a direct pressure in through there. So I'll have her get in that lunge position again. That's going to put the iliopsoas in a little bit of a stretch. She's just going to shift her body weight forward, put pressure in there. As you do that, it's gonna be a deep feeling of almost like a little ache, but that's getting into those hip flexors. Those hip flexors, again, are attaching onto the lumbar spine and pelvis. We're gonna go ahead and let those release. Spend about 20 to 30 seconds on this. You can even spend up to a minute if you'd like. Hold that there. Once you feel like that release has happened, then go ahead and go on to the next spot.